Hi everyone, and welcome to another video in the series of statistical software in criminal justice, where we will cover the bivariate analysis of categorical variables in SPSS. In this video, we will use one of the SPSS's most helpful commands to construct a table in which the values of one variable are crosstabulated with the values of the other variable. This table is called Crosstabulation, or Crosstab for short. It is also known as a contingency table because one variable is contingent or depends on the other. We will look to find an association, which means that the two variables are related to the extent that knowing a person's attribute in one variable will help us guess the person's attribute on the other. Generally, there are two measures of association for categorical variables, and that is lambda, which is a measure of association appropriate for use when both variables are nominal or one variable is nominal and the other is ordinal. Gamma is another measure of association appropriate for use with ordinal variables. So we have here a data set, General Social Survey 2018 revised, because it's not the whole data set. It's a data set that has fewer variables, about only 102 variables. And we're going to look at two categorical variables and how they are associated with each other. We're going to look at the idea that marital status sort of affects the opinion of a person on favoring or opposing gun permits. So we're going to look at two variables, marital, which is the marital status, and gun law over here, which is favor or oppose gun permits. So the first thing that we generally do is to get a frequency table for both variables. Usually we go to analyze, descriptive statistics, and then frequencies. In frequencies, we get the two variables, gun law and marital, into the variable box. Display frequency tables is selected. Then we click OK. So here we see that there are about 71.5% of the participants favor gun permits. Okay, they do not favor just guns, they favor gun permits. And 28.5% oppose gun permits. In the marital status, we have about 42.5% married, 28.6% unmarried, and the other three in between. So here we cannot see, for example, how many among the married participants favor or oppose gun permits, or how many among never married favor or oppose gun permits. In order to do that, we have to create a crosstabulation or a contingency table where one variable will be in the rows and the other one will be in the columns. So to create that crosstabulation, we usually go to analyze, descriptive statistics, and then crosstabs. The crosstabs dialog box opens up, and then we have all the variables in the left field. And then we have two fields in the right side, rows and columns. So the research question here is that a person's marital status will affect that person's opinion on gun permits. The independent variable here would be the marital status, because that is the one that we think affects the other. An independent variable generally goes into the columns. There are other authors that put the independent variable in the rows, but here we're going to put the independent variable in the columns. So marital will go in the columns, and gun law will go in the rows. Now there are some options on the right. One of the options is the cells. In the cell, generally, SPSS gives us the observed values in the data set, okay? But we're gonna get some percentages. And keep this in mind that when you put the independent variable in the columns, then you have to request column percentages. That is going to make more sense when you compare the attributes percentages among the row. So you ask for column percentages, and here we click continue. Here we're going to display clustered bar charts. We're not going to get anything from the other options, and we're just going to click OK. So the Crosstab output is visible now in the output window of the SPSS. The first table is the case processing summary that gives us the valid and missing percentages and values. The most important table is the cross-tabulation between gun law and marital status. So as you can see, marital status is in the columns and gun law is in the rows. Marital status has five categories: married, widowed, divorced, separated, and never married. And gun law has only two categories: favor or oppose. As you can see, the percentages that we requested are down the column. So this percentage here, together with this one, make 100%. Therefore, in the married category, 70.2% favor and 29.8% oppose gun permits, and so on in the other categories. However, to make sense of the differences, we ask for column percentages so that we can compare percentages across the row. So 70.2, 74.2, and so on. So what do we see when we compare these percentages? We see that married, widowed, divorced, and never married have a very small percentage difference. The only category that has a larger percentage difference is separated. And we do have a statistic, which is a simple statistic called Epsilon, that actually is used to calculate these differences. So the biggest difference here is between the widowed and separated, and that is 74.2% minus 62.1%. That's about 12% epsilon, or 12% difference. The same thing can be seen in the oppose row. So 29.8%, 25.8%, 26.7%, and 27.4%, compared to the almost 38% that oppose gun permits in the category of those who are separated. One thing that we need to keep in mind is that the separated category is the smallest category with only 58 participants here. So in the general scheme of things, that doesn't really have much significance. So these differences, although you may see that separated is much more different as an opinion than the other, generally, we probably might not see any large significance here. This can be seen also in the bar chart. The first group of bars is favor and the second is oppose. The pattern of the height of the bars is similar. So the biggest bar is married, but why? Because married has the largest number of participants, and the smallest is separated, which is the fourth bar from the left. Okay, but the pattern of the height of the bars, or the percentages, or even the counts remain the same in both categories, favor or oppose. So generally, that's all we can see with the cross-tabulations. We look at differences between categories among the categories of the other variable. And as we can see, marital, we said that is independent variable, the one that sorts of affects or impacts the opinion on the dependent variable or outcome, whether or not participants favored or opposed gun permits. We can do much more than only cross-tabulation with categorical variables and the association between them. Please check out my next video, Chi-Square in SPSS. I hope you enjoyed this one. Thank you for watching.